for Coldplay.
Where is he? Where is Paul? Has anyone seen him?
Don't worry, Chris. I'll save this day. Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you, Chris. I'm sure I took cold. I'm just kidding, everybody. It's me. Superman. It's me. I say I'm not Superman anyway, because I'm Batman. So, yeah, we're going to do a little bit of talk about branding today. But first, what I want to do is I want to give you a little bit of my sort of history into why I'm talking about superheroes. So that's me, 11 years old. I think I just started to grow my beard a couple of weeks after that photo was taken. And I was a really big comic book fan as a kid. I used to get the Beano and the Dandy from my grandparents. And I remember one day, I think it was a Wednesday, it used to come out, and my gran went up to the shop and she came back and she told me that they'd both sold out. And I was really, really, really upset, an upset 10-year-old. But she didn't let me down. She said, I've got you something else. I don't know if you'll like it. So she gave me this thing and put it on my lap. And it was like, whoa, what the is this? I was 10, didn't swear. And what it was an American comic. And it was totally different to everything that I'd read before. The differences were, these people, these heroes were drawn in a realistic way. All their forms were correct. Whereas I was reading Beano and the Dandy, and it was all kind of caricature stuff, sort of madcap humor. And this was a little bit more violent. And the story behind Secret Wars, and it just seems when I look back, it was the right one to land in my lap at the time, because the storyline of Secret Wars is that there's a big baddie and he's kidnapped all of Earth's heroes and all of Earth's villains and put them on another planet and just wants to watch them fight one another. Awesome for a 10-year-old, awesome. And awesome for a 42-year-old, to be honest. And what got me, what struck me even at that age was there were pages and pages of 20, 30 heroes and villains fighting one another, but you could tell who they were. They all stood out. You knew where Spider-Man was, you knew where Captain America was, and you could make out the baddies. And that kind of led me on to really looking into sort of character design and color. And I know that kind of there's studies done that say 3-year-olds can recognize a McDonald's logo and stuff before they can read. But I wasn't really into junk food at that age. And so for me, it was logos. Superhero logos and branding. And I do firmly believe that that is kind of the starting point of my journey into wanting to do design and character design. So this, I could name every single character that you can see on that screen and ones that are probably in the background. Why am I telling you this? Well, there's a really good reason that I'm using superheroes to talk about branding today, and that's because superheroes are masters at branding. And I know this because there will be certain superheroes that you in this room know. You will know. You don't need to see their face, you don't need to see all of them, you can see a bit of a costume, you can see a bit of a logo, a bit of a symbol, and you go, that's Batman, that's Superman. That's great branding. That's just like McDonald's, that's just like Coca-Cola. But superheroes do it better. I want to test the room's knowledge, because there's going to be people here who have some brand knowledge and some don't. So just shout out what you think makes up a good brand. What's a good element of a brand? Yeah, logo? Since you say symbol?
Colors. Name.
Colors.
Name.
Yeah, memorable. That's a good one. Message is a good one.
Values is a really good one. Those are pretty much, you've nailed it. Those are pretty much, let me see what my notes actually say. You've pretty much nailed it. The only one that isn't there is consistency. Consistency is important in your branding. And we'll touch on all of that as we go through. I'm sure that most of the people in this room will get pretty much all of those across the board. Maybe second one in on the top, some people wouldn't get. That's Green Lantern, by the way. And I've kind of done a good thing. I've mixed in some DC comics. I'm wearing DC comics. I'm a Marvel fan, but this was always in Primark, so I didn't really have much of a choice. So they're instantly recognizable, even as a potato. You know that Spider-Man, Spider-Tato? It's the costume, it's the colors, it's the branding. It just works. It instantly triggers that Spider-Man. The hero's personality. There's a thing in branding called your tone of voice. And your tone of voice is how you communicate to your audience. And that generally is in the way you write your content, the way you write your marketing. And a superhero's tone of voice is based around their personality. So if we go sort of from left to right and we talk about Spider-Man, Peter Parker, he's a teenager, so his tone of voice is pretty irreverent and it's witty and he's wisecracking. So that's, you can imagine his marketing being a little bit more out there, a bit like BrewDog probably, in terms of his tone of voice. Oh, too far. And then we've got Superman, who's a bloody do-gooder and is just boring. Really, really boring. I will do what I did and save my presentation today on. Bit of drama would be good. And that's why, I know he's DC, but that's why I like Batman. Batman's tone of voice is pretty dark. It's dark, it's vengeful. And the reason it's like that is because he wants to strike fear into the hearts of his enemies. Anybody here have a tone of voice that strikes fear into the heart of their customers? Niche. Ricky Ross, my PT, yeah. No, Ricky's like Superman, he's super nice. Super nice. So we're getting on to consistency. I got this for my Christmas this year. It's huge. This is 75 years of comic book covers. Like I said, I'm a geek. And what you'll see is there's four ages of comic book heroes. There's the Golden Age, Silver Age, Bronze Age, and the Modern Age. Most of the comics that you will kind of know, like the Hulk, Fantastic Four, Spider-Man, they started in the Silver Age, which is the 60s. If you look through this book and you go from the 60s to the 70s to the 80s to the 90s to this, and look at the covers and look at the logos and look at the costumes, look at the branding, it hasn't changed. It'll tweak, it'll look a little bit more modern, but someone from the 60s, if they came now and went to find their favorite Fantastic Four comic or their X-Men comic, the branding is exactly the same. The consistency there is, it's phenomenal. And a lot of good companies don't follow that. I mean, 75 years of sticking to the brand and sticking to the same message is going to stick that up into your head. Now we've got a quiz. It'd be a dead simple quiz. All the questions are going to appear up there at once because I didn't want to risk any PowerPoint animations and it failing. So here's our questions, right? So just shout out. So question one, what's Superman's weakness? Correct. What's Batman's butler called? Correct. Peter Parker is who? What makes Bruce Banner turn into the Hulk? You wouldn't like him when he's angry. Now, something funny about that, pretty much everybody in this room knew the answers to that. But that's not their logo. It's not their costume, you're not seeing a picture of them, you're not seeing a comic strip, but you know the answers to these. And the answers to these are what are called brand associations. So when you think of a brand, your brain triggers thoughts, feelings, emotions, and other links. And the way superheroes do that to you is that they, because you've seen them in film, you've seen them on TV, you've read the comic books, and the stories are dramatic, they do empathize. Ali, there's empathy in superhero comics. And there's drama, and that causes emotion in the human brain. And where there's emotion, you will hold on to facts and images much more easily. So 75 years of superhero stories, it's all in here. Everybody knew the answers to that quiz really, really easily. Here's a couple of superheroes and some of their brand associations. And you'll probably all look at these and know what they are. You know, you've seen them in the dark, but, you know, Robin, the Joker, Bruce Wayne, Alfred, Gotham City, Batmobile, Batcave, Batphone, Batbath, whatever. He's got Bat everything. Then you've got Spider-Man. And we've got things like Aunt May, Peter Parker, Green Goblin. He's a teenager, as we've already kind of said. Red and blue costume. Now, that's the thing. Captain America's costume is red and blue. There are hundreds of superheroes that costumes are red and blue. But you can differentiate them at a glance. That's the really cool thing. It's really, really simple. I thought I'd better throw a female here one year because Chris talking about getting more female speakers and stuff. And because there aren't enough female superheroes. Thankfully, there's a lot more films coming out now where they're the main character. But Wonder Woman is maybe a little bit less known. Films may help that, but I'm kind of going by the 70s TV series. Anybody else watch 70s TV series? Yeah. So the Lasso of Truth, Bulletproof Bracelets, Strength Costume, her name's Diane, she had an invisible plane, which was really cool. So what can we learn from superheroes? How can we apply that to your brand? Because brands and businesses, or businesses, sorry, who are creating brands, often do it in a really shit way. What they'll do is they will go, what are we selling? What's our service? What's our product? Right, let's create a brand around that. Let's kind of sell this. Let's write some content. Let's some marketing about it. But that's a thing. That's a thing. That's a commodity. People don't relate to commodities. They relate to superheroes because they're people. So what you need to do is not make your brand about a thing. That's the thing, not a thing. That's the thing. And so by doing that, by making your brand relatable, you will get much more impact and people will be attracted to you much more easily. So you need to think about your brand as a superhero and work that way up and do what you do. Relatable. I did not want to put a stock image up here. I couldn't find any heroes shaking hands and stuff, so I wouldn't sully myself by using a crappy business handshake. I was tempted to draw some spikes on it, like Batman's glove or something, but I didn't have the time. So what we need to do is we need to, like I say, from the ground up, start again and look at your brand from a different viewpoint. Look at it from the point of a superhero. So we've got a superhero checklist that I want you all to write down as it comes up. Now, they're all going to come up once again because again I can't be bothered with animations. Here we go. Right, so the first one is your brand superpower. Now, you're not going to have X-ray vision and you're not going to be able to fly and you're not going to have invisibility. It's going to be more ground-based. So what you need to do, what is your biggest strength in your brand? You know, what does the product do? What does it help people to, you know, what does it help people to achieve? How does it help others? And by focusing on those, you'll be able to kind of build up a picture if you've got a team, definitely get the team in, because you'll get different aspects of what people think is a strong core for your brand, your brand values. And you will come up with more than one, but they'll all have different levels of strength. So you'll have your main superpower, and then in different areas you'll be able to pull in these smaller superpowers. And then you've got your purpose. So your purpose is basically, what is it you're trying to change in the world? For superheroes, it's justice. They want justice in all different kinds of ways. Maybe you do want justice, it depends on what you do, but you need to figure out what it is you want to make a difference in the world with. What do you want to inspire people to do? What's your business's goal for that? Then you've got the tone of voice, which we talked about. So this is where you really need to think, put your business, put your product there, put a little cape on it, and imagine speaking to it. How does it sound? What's its personality? Because that's your tone of voice, and you need to stick to your tone of voice, because there's no point in having a cutesy type thing and having Batman's voice coming out of it, because that would be quite scary. And then next, what we have is your costume. So you might think, a lot of people think a logo is your brand, but a logo is quite far down the list in terms of what you need to do first. So the first three are important. Then you develop your costume, which is your logo and your symbol and your branding materials. That is what you wear. That is the trigger. That's what makes people then think, oh, I associate that with that brand, whether it be fun, whether it be trust, whether it be seriousness. The costume and the logo and the branding will do that for you. So it needs to be cool as well. It needs to be really cool. And it needs to be simple as possible. A bit like superhero symbols and logos, you know, they're really, really simple and really colourful. But you don't have to be really colourful. It just needs to be striking. And then lastly is the stories, because that's what's going to make the brand association stick. And I speak to a lot of clients, more so in the past year, about creating stories, thanks to kind of speaking to Kevin, who's like master storyteller, superpower storyteller. And I have people who are accountants. I've not got any stories. Our business is really, really bloody boring. Stories aren't about you. It's not about you. Well, I spent 3 hours on the calculator today. Pretty cool. No. Make the stories about your customers. How has it impacted their lives? Tell others, because others will have those problems. And we had that earlier on with Vicky's content stuff. Problems were huge. We've all got problems. If you can make your stories about fixing those problems and going deeper and telling people what the problem was and the journey, that builds emotion, which builds the link, which builds everything and makes it lock into your head. So by thinking of creating a brand as a superhero, it's more fun. You might have a boring product, but whack a cape on it. It's much more fun, much more creative. You'll have a laugh doing it. If you have a laugh doing it, then it's going to come across in sort of your passion for it. If you're kind of going, oh, we've got to come up with a little ISO over there. Got to come up with a logo. Oh, can't be bothered. If you put a cape on it, you'll have a great time. So all I can say is, go forth, create your brand, save the world. And one last thing, I've got a new superhero. That's his logo. It's called Rock Your Brand, and it's basically a free Facebook group which I made public at 4:30 a.m. this morning whilst I was doing my slides. It's my superpower. procrastinationlastminuteman.com. So yeah, Let's Rock Your Brand. So it's facebook.com/ Let's Rock Your Brand. It's free. I'm going to be launching it now, and I'm going to be in there every week, and I want people who are building brands, have brands, to come in and share their experiences. I'll be sharing my knowledge, I'll be doing webinars, I'm going to be interviewing other kind of thought leaders in the branding industry, getting them all in. I've got Andrew and Pete lined up to interview who are going to be at the conference. They are absolutely mental. I'm really looking forward to that. That'll be great. God knows what their superhero is going to be like. But yeah, I'm really, really excited about this. This is a big thing for me. This is really pushing me kind of out of my comfort zone to do this group. So I would love for you all to join, and I'd love for you all to really try the superhero exercise. Take your current brand, create a superhero, doodle it, put it into the group so that we can all kind of have, maybe have a laugh, but give feedback and see how it's all going. So, yeah. Oh, I need to put this down, because I need to say, stay creative, folks. Thanks very much.
Awesome. So good. So everything that Paul does encapsulates branding, as you can clearly tell. I think it's really interesting, right, just to look at superheroes, something that we all kind of like, is there around all of us. The films, especially now, it's really grown. But it's really cool to just see how it relates to our own brand and business as well. Like, our brand sucks so bad. Like, when I look at that sort of stuff, and I know we're working on it, we're working with Ross and Call as a collaboration on our brand as well, because I just don't think it just doesn't cut it, right? It's boring. It looks rubbish. And it just doesn't feel right.
I didn't do this one. That's not my work.
It just doesn't feel right. I'll say it. It's fine when I say it. It doesn't feel right. There's something not right about it. It's not fun. It's not cool. It's not the way it should be. You guys, I'll talk to you about that as we close up today and give you a bit of feedback on that. But that's how I feel about my brand. I know that it's capable of much, much more. When I see people, other people doing great work with their brand, I just feel like it's got to step up, right? Got to step up to the plate for this. So thanks for that insight. That was really, really great, Paul. Thanks for all your efforts there. That's really insightful. Brilliant. Another round of applause for our superhero today. Some amazing pictures on Twitter as well.